Hey guys, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and in this video I'm going to answer the question, what happens when I stop taking creatine? I'll have the answer for you in just a couple of seconds. Stick around, I'll be right back. All right, welcome back. Thanks so much for sticking around. So if you're wondering what happens when I stop taking creatine, here's what you need to know. The first thing you're going to notice is that you're going to drop some weight on the scales. Now, it won't happen overnight, but within a couple of days to a week of stopping your creatine, you're going to notice that you weigh anywhere from a couple of pounds to as many as 10 pounds or maybe a little more less. Now, a lot of people freak out when this happens because they assume that what they're losing is muscle and all the gains they worked so hard for are slowly going down the drain. Relax. That's not what's happening here. Creatine is very effective at drawing water into the muscle cells, and the weight you're losing is water weight. Your gains, whatever gains you did make, are not impacted. Now, the other thing you're going to notice is that you look flatter physically, and what I mean by this is you're going to look less pumped or swole. This too has to do with the water that is no longer being held in your muscles, which helps give you a more pumped look. And of course, your performance in the gym is also going to be affected. Not your aerobic activities. Studies show creatine has minimal to no effect on cardio-related activities, but instead, your performance with anaerobic activities like weight training will be affected. Of course, if you regularly phone in your workouts, you probably won't notice much when you stop taking creatine. On the other hand, if you're the type of person who makes every rep count and pushes out every last one with each and every set, you're definitely going to notice that you gas out earlier, and it makes perfect sense that you do. The way creatine works is that it provides the raw material for the anaerobic energy creation process in the muscle cell. So if you're not maintaining peak saturation by taking a daily dose of creatine, you're not going to be able to do as much work. Now, if you're not liking the answer to the question, what happens when I stop taking creatine? Well, the solution is actually pretty easy. Take a short break and cycle back on the stuff. All these effects will be reversed within a week or so of starting back up again. Remember, long-term studies have been performed on vulnerable populations taking creatine safely for periods of up to 2 years. So unless you have an underlying health issue or kidney problems, don't feel like you gotta cycle off the stuff every couple of weeks. Okay guys, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, a thumbs up would be awesome. If you have any questions or comments about cycling off creatine, please leave them below. If you're interested in learning more about the sorts of results taking creatine can bring you, you'll find a link to my creatine results video on the screen here in a moment. Lastly, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. There's an icon here to my right that you can click, or just use the little red subscribe button just a little further below this video. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you really soon.